Currently, Hydra is in Samoa, and in particular, it's on the island of Savai, which is the area that we've decided to focus on for this three-leg series of expeditions in Samoa.
We're looking to understand and investigate mesophotic reef ecosystems.
The mesophotic zone is kind of a transition zone between the shallow reef and the deep sea, between 30 meters and 150 meters depth.
What we're trying to achieve is understanding the role that mesophotic ecosystems might have in resilience for tropical environments.
Everything starts with an understanding of the bathymetry in the region. Aboard Hydra, we have very advanced mapping systems which allow us to measure differences in the height of the seafloor at great precision.
Happy to go in the ocean.
We then do an oceanographic component that tells us about what is the ocean currents doing in that space, how is that bathymetry interacting with the movement of water, and how those nutrients from the deep sea is transferred into the shallows, and how then that might impact the coral communities and the fish communities which rely on those corals as well. The second leg then focuses on some benthic habitat mapping and is focused largely on the coral communities that we encounter in these tropical reef locations, gaining a better understanding of not only their genetics, but how they're distributed across the islands.
Ready, 3, 2, 1, go.
We'll be using a combination of autonomous underwater vehicles or underwater robots, as well as deep divers, doing very high resolution photogrammetry to create a 3D reconstruction of the reef.
By using these photogrammetry techniques, we're able to generate a permanent stamp in time of what that reef looked like in great detail that we can then come back to in the future and see how things have changed.
1, 2, 3, 9.
On leg 3 of this expedition, we're taking genetic samples from fishes and from clams. The fishes that we're interested in sampling are fishes which are really common, and they're really common throughout the Pacific. Giant clams are an indicator species for climate change. They also have zooxanthellae, the same as corals, and they can bleach. So we're interested in the patterns of genetic connectivity for those clams across the Pacific.
Going.
One of the tools that we use a lot is the baited remote underwater video systems. That then allows us to say something about the biomass. And it's biomass which is key for understanding fisheries in the long term. We've been really fortunate that we've been able to dive the submersible several times on this expedition.
It's cool, eh?
So we're gathering a really good picture of what it is that these deep marine habitats in Samoa look like.
Beautiful, isn't it? An unusual sighting.
Yeah.
The local support is critical. Without it, a lot of things wouldn't happen.
Oh, look at that.
Illegal octopus.
Oh, wow, that's cool.
And we're really fortunate in this case that we've got a representative from the Ministry of Natural Resources and Environment on board. That's helping us to liaise with the local communities, keeping them informed about our activities so that we are courteous guests in their backyard.
I'm here to learn. And this research is really, really important to the Ministry of Natural Resources and also Ministry of Agriculture and Fisheries in Samoa.
What we're trying to deliver is a complete package of information that's valuable to the nation of Samoa. What is the state of those reefs now in great detail? But it's also a permanent record of what that reef looked like forever into the future.